President Marcos says he is horrified over the idea Philippine sovereignty was compromised over an alleged secret deal struck by his predecessor. It was Attorney Harry Roque, former spokesperson of former President Rodrigo Duterte, who confirmed that Duterte agreed to a compromise deal with Chinese leader Xi Jinping on the West Philippine Sea issue. But another Duterte spokesman, Attorney Salvador Panelo, later denied such a deal was struck. Marcos says until now they are still unsure of the existence of that supposed agreement.
It turns out we don't know. It is a secret agreement. We don't know anything about it. There is no documentation. There is no record. There is no... We were not briefed when I came into office. Walang nagsabi sa amin na merong ganung usapan. So we're trying to really, up to now, because from the former administration, iba-ibang sagot eh. Sabi ng isang official, dating government official under the previous administration, there's no such agreement. Sabi naman ng isa, no, there is and we should honor it. Sabi naman ng iba, maganda yan. Sabi ng iba, hindi maganda yan. Hindi pa namin alam kung ano ba talaga yung agreement na yan. Kung ang sinasabi sa agreement na yan na kailangan tayong magpermiso sa ibang bansa para gumalaw sa ating sariling teritoryo, mahirap siguro sundan yung ganyang klaseng agreement. I am horrified by the idea that we have compromised through a secret agreement the territory, the sovereignty, and the sovereign rights of the Philippines.
The Philippine poll body vows greater transparency in the 2025 midterm polls. Unlike in the previous automated election system, COMELEC says it separated the contracts for the software that will be used to transmit votes and the automated vote counting machines. For the transmission system, the contract was awarded to Filipino firms I1 Resources and Ardent Networks. Meanwhile, Miro Systems will supply the automated vote counting machines for the 2025 polls. The poll body adds, the new automated election system will undergo a source code review and should pass international certification. COMELEC will also ditch the transparency server used in previous elections.
Lahat ng mga wala before, nilagay natin lahat ngayon. There will be a send to all feature of this transmission, meaning to say there will be no more the so-called transparency server. Yung transparency server kasi pag nabulunan, hindi na nakakakuha ng results. More importantly, under the feature of the transmission, the DICT will have a mirror on the whatever the results are sent to our data center.
Follow the law to the letter. That's the appeal of Senator Loren Legarda as issues on the destruction of protected areas emerge. She says the gap is clearly on the implementation of several measures already in place to ensure the conservation of protected areas. She also asserts the Environment Department is not blameless on the construction of the controversial Captain's Peak Resort in Bohol's Chocolate Hills.
Before 2018, when the expanded NIPAS law was legislated, na isa batas po ito, may mga tao na po. May mga nagpatitulo na po. May mga prior rights. Yan po ay dinirespeto ng batas. However, even if you have a title to the land, the way you treat the land, yung paggamit po ng lupa ay dapat sang-ayon sa batas. In this case, the DENR is the implementing agency. So we created the PAMBI and the PAMBI will come out. Gagawa po siya ng isang environment management plan. In that management plan, it must be consistent with the law. And what does the law say? Enhancement of biological diversity against human exploitation. They must not just close it, but really just delete it.
As for the issue on the contract of the Masungi Geo Reserve, she says while the legal aspect should be looked into, she believes the work of the foundation can be a model in the conservation of protected areas. Legarda also appealing to the Prisons Bureau to rethink its plan of building a headquarters in the area.
Alam natin ang ibang mga protected areas inaabuso. Alam natin hindi sustainable ang pag-develop ng mga ibang protected areas. Ito, maaring modelo at sa aking kaalaman, maganda at magaling at mukhang may puso ang mga namamahala dito. Kung ako ang Bucor, please naman po, huwag kayong magtayo dyan ng anumang gusali. Maaring pag-aari ninyo, ibalik na nyo sa Republic of the Philippines at gawin na lang yung conservation. Please lang. Hindi naman lahat ng napatituluhan ay tama. I think it would be foolish for them to move there.